The Cricket World Cup begins in a month, and Indians will surely go the distance to cheer in the stands. But it's the rupee volatility causing many travellers to put off their travel plans. I had a chat with Mahesh Iyer of Thomas Cook to know more about the trends this season, starting with the impact of the currency fluctuations. Listen.
Typically, you see, there is a bit of an impact. I wouldn't say there's no impact, but look at it as a package price. Typically, a holiday for a family of four consists of about $4,000 or $5,000 that he needs to pay towards the holiday. So to that extent, an impact of about 2 or 3 rupees really makes a big difference for a traveler. So to that extent, yes, it is cheaper to buy that holiday. And the last few weeks, we've seen the trend of the rupee inching back closer to the 70 mark. But I think if you look at it traditionally, the rupee has been depreciating by about 5% year on year. So to that extent, kind of people anticipate this moment to happen. But yes, compared to last year, this year, I think they have a little more money to have in their hands. And we think that is a great opportunity because people will have more money to spend while on their holiday. So to that extent, it's a good boon to have a bit of an appreciating rupee that leaves a little more money in the hands of the people.
But nonetheless, you're saying there is no pushback of holidays, even the outbound ones, despite currency coming back to 70.
Oh, definitely not. I have been saying this for a long time. Holiday as a category is never pushed back. You know, there could be some bit of deviation, some bit of postponement that will happen, but people definitely don't cancel their holidays. We are in the peak of the holiday season and everyone has plans for holidaying. So clearly a bit of a moment in rupee is not going to deter that plan. Yes, they may cut back a little bit on their shopping money or something of that sort, but clearly a holiday as a category is not compromised anymore. So it's basically a necessity in today, and people who have planned for the holiday would definitely go forward with it. So we have not witnessed any bit of a change or any reduction in their travel plans as a result of either the appreciating rupee or the bit of a turbulence that we have seen in the aviation industry.
So we're already entering the holiday season now somewhere. How would you say you would compare this year versus last year in terms of the initial sense that you're getting and the initial bookings that have come in? Is it a better year?
Yeah, it is definitely a better year. If I compare our holiday season this year as compared to last year, we're actually witnessing over 22% growth in our forward bookings, and that's a very healthy number. The peak growth is coming from the European market, which has been a stronghold for us. We've also seen some strong growth coming from the Asia markets or continents such as US, South Africa, have all seen double-digit growth. Europe has been a front runner there with over 25% growth compared to the previous holiday season.
Do you think that much of it with regards to the Cricket World Cup, Wimbledon, all of that has already been factored in terms of the Euro bookings, and you've already pre-received those bookings, or somewhere closer to the end of May, you may actually see more of those bookings?
So yes, there are multiple factors. One, as I said, it coincides with the peak holiday season. We did anticipate that there could be some impact on account of elections, but contrary to our belief, there have been no impact on account of elections in India. People are willing to travel. And as you know, most of the elections get over by the 19th of May. So we have a bunch of a booking actually happening after the third week of May, extending right up to end of June, and in markets like North India, where it will extend up to end of July. Yes, the World Cup fever is something that has caught the larger audience. We have a healthy pipeline of people wanting to travel to the UK to watch the World Cup, and the critical matches of India, Pakistan, India, Australia are a kind of a big draw. The large amount of requests that we've got is from the corporate customers, especially on the MICE segment, where there are a lot of bulk bookings that we have got, where people want to package that along with a kind of an event for them to watch the match at the stadium and package it for the dealer. So we've seen a lot of bulk bookings coming from our corporates. Yes, there are individual inquiries, but that's more from the millennial segments, not the family. Family typically still looks to the holiday per se, and for them it's touching multiple parts of Europe and not necessarily London by itself. But it's more the B2B segments, that's the corporate and the MICE segment, where we have seen a lot of bulk bookings, especially for the cricketing.
In the month of Feb and March, and there was a brokerage report that came out that suggested that hotel occupancy rates have shot up significantly. Can we correlate that in terms of tourism and travel and probably see a reflection of that for Thomas Cook as well?
Look, we witnessed some amount of hardening of rates, more importantly on the domestic side, but I think it's something that had to happen, because if you look at it for the last 3 or 4 years, the hotel rates have been very subdued because of a lot of cutthroat competition. But I think now bit of a supply, I would say a lot of hotel properties are still coming up, but you know, the number of people traveling have actually gone up. So there's a bit of a, I would say, supply side constraint in some form, with not all the hotel properties being ready. And I think with the kind of commissioning, with the kind of discounting that's happening, the hotels have also realized that they need to make money in this business. So we've seen a bit of a hardening of rates, that's about 5 or 6%. And I think it's a good trend to happen, because at the end of the day, you've got to have everyone in the ecosystem making money. If they're not going to make money, they're not going to make further investments into it. And that will become detrimental to the overall growth of this industry. So I think a bit of a hardening of rate is something that we welcome it. And on the domestic side, we've seen that reflecting into our package prices. A bit of hardening of the rates are reflective in the package prices. But as I said, considering the category of holiday, it has become, while it is discretionary by nature, I think it's become compulsory to spend.
With regards to the destination management business, Mr. Iyer, could you throw some light on what's been the progress with regards to inbound and outbound business?
So destination management companies are largely inbound companies, focusing on travelers coming into their respective markets. So we have operations in Asia, we have operations in India, we have operations in Australia, we have in South Africa and East Africa. So in all those markets, I think we've seen more than double digit growth. In fact, for the last quarter, the quarter ended December, the report results for which we had declared, 3 of our 5 destination management companies have already broken even or reported cash profits. Two other units, more importantly, the markets in Eastern Africa and Southern Africa are a little while away from breaking even. Our sense is that before the end of FY20, they should be breaking even or posting cash profits for their respective operations. Clearly, what we have seen within the India context, the inbound numbers into India have actually grown. We've witnessed over 16% growth in our sales volume. Mm-hmm. And in terms of passengers, we've seen about 8% growth in our PAX numbers. So clearly, we've seen some growth momentum in both those businesses, and the inbound business just got over for India in the month of March. So we had some strong momentum coming in both those businesses, and we see that trajectory to continue.